This video introduces d.tools, a tool that enables rapid and reflective prototyping of physical user interfaces. As computing leaves our desktops and enters our world, the number of user interfaces with novel physical form factors and advanced sensor inputs is growing quickly. d.tools is the first system that offers integrated support for designing, testing, and analyzing early prototypes that bridge the worlds of bits and atoms. The following scenario shows how designers can rapidly build and evaluate with d.tools. Sam is an interaction designer who wants to create a novel map navigation interface for a handheld GPS device based on orientation sensors. He connects a small LCD screen for display and an accelerometer to the d.tools hardware interface kit. As he plugs in physical components, virtual counterparts appear in the d.tools authoring environment on his PC. Sam then authors interactions by creating visual states, which encapsulate output, and linking them through transitions, which get triggered by hardware input events. In this example, Sam is authoring map zooming through button presses. To help his work with analog sensors, Sam can author transitions by demonstrating them in physical space. Here he is setting thresholds for an accelerometer by tilting it and setting limits in the live data view using the keyboard. At any point, he can try out his interaction model by using the attached hardware inputs, or by simulating such hardware input on the PC. After trying out some initial interaction ideas, Sam designs a more durable prototype to test different interactions with office mates and users. To increase the realism of the test, he asked Jim, a programmer's office, to add navigation of a live map database. Jim attaches a few lines of Java to different states in order to remote control the Google Maps application. This is an example of how d.tools can be used to create mashup prototypes, an approach that is becoming increasingly common. In test mode, d.tools records all user interactions with a prototype, simultaneously recording a time-synchronized video stream of the user's interaction with a device. The video is automatically structured through state transitions and input events. During the test, the designer can also annotate segments of the video for later review. Switching from test to analyze mode, Sam sees an overview of the interaction model during the last test. This aggregate view shows which transitions were taken most frequently and which ones were never reached during the test. In analyze mode, the state chart is synchronized with the video interface, allowing our designers to replay the user's interactions in parallel with the video, visualize timeline events as they appear in the state chart, and quickly jump to video of particular states both through the state chart and through the physical prototype. Multiple categories can be selected, allowing a designer to pinpoint a particular interaction by replaying it on the device. Multiple test sessions can be combined into a video spreadsheet, which can be used for rapid, comparative evaluation. Individual clips can be played simultaneously. Clips can also be triggered by clicking on the corresponding event on the timeline. Additionally, clicking on a column plays a single category for comparison across all users. We employed three different methods to understand the interaction and architectural approaches embodied in d.tools. We evaluated the threshold with a first use study with 13 participants, the ceiling through rebuilding prototypes for existing and emerging devices, and naturalistic use through longitudinal deployment in an HCI class. Projects built with d.tools by students and authors include a digital camera interface with a large number of buttons to navigate images and menus on a color LCD screen, a sensing PDA that can detect portrait and landscape mode, scroll by tilting the device, and plays voice memos when held up to the face, a color mixing interface where children can pour color from tangible buckets onto an LCD screen and then use that color in a painting application, tangible drawers that offer access to personal data on an interactive multi-user table. We have released d.tools to the design community as open source.